kam ještě nejvíc vize. Jmenu se zakouká. Já bych noch ještě přišený. Musíte být jistě, že a jen dnes zóny bych mu tady do toho form kriju. No a když se jistě, co mám se jistě na jen, a jen, o zapost být jistě, ale on nebude join us, since já jde, spolu bych jistě. Musíte Suresh Babuji, director MSNB. Mr. Venkateswaran, Zone Lead NSAC, Mr. Lakappan, President Tamil Nadu Plastic Packaging Association, Mr. Basic, Plastics and Packaging Consultant, Madam Sarika Yadav, Regional Head, South Rim Capital, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Head Sales, E-Sales Stores, Mr. Sulakar, Past Chairman of Indian Plastic Flex Council, Mr. Shekhar, Chairman, Past Chairman of Indian Plastic Institute and Committee Member of Plast India, Mr. Robert Hanray, he is the regional director. Dignitaries on dais, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. On behalf of the Plastic Export Promotion Council, I welcome each one of you this morning to the very important session on Export Awareness Week. I extend a warm welcome to all of you to the Export Awareness Program on the current scenario and the way forward for Indian plastic industry. This is jointly organized by the Zonal Joint Director General of Foreign Trade, Chennai, and Council in association with DARPA, mainly for the benefit of the members and for the industry and for the fraternity, plastic community. Friends, as you're all aware, news from the export front has not been very encouraging, particularly due to the slowdown of developed countries for reasons well known to us. Added to the mystery is the COVID-19. However, exports did show signs of turnaround during last two quarters of 19 and 20, but the prolonged slowdown has adversely impacted exporters' market diversification efforts. The matter is of great concern to not only all of us, but also to the government of India, who are taking steps to avoid the situation by putting back exports back on the high track growth. During 18-19, India exported plastic worth of $10.9 billion against 7.5 billion in 2018, registering growth of 23.1%, which is phenomenal considering the global meltdown. The Plex Council's aggressive growth strategies and plans are on the anvil to substantially grow our exports, particularly in the coming quarters and coming years.
Respected Sir Dr. M.K. Chandrasekaran, IAS, Development Commissioner, MEPS, Chennai. Respected Sir Dr. D.H. Respected Dr. Sir D.K. Shekhar, AADAS, Zonal Additional DGFT at Chennai. Respected Madam Mrs. Sudha Gautam, Commissioner of Customs, Chennai, Customs Sea Exports. Mr. Chair Y.V. Raman, Chairman, Southern Regional Association. I welcome all for coming to this function. DARPA is more than 34 years old organization doing best service to the plastic fraternity. I am glad to inform you that today is one of the important day where it will be remembered and will get into the history books of DARPA. We are very much delighted in having the officials from customs, DGFT, MAPS, MSME, NSAC and other Tamil Nadu state government officers in a single platform to address the needs of our trade. Friends, we are gathering at the right time where the whole world economy is facing severe headwinds across the different sectors for all the well-known reasons, and in respect to that, our industry is also likely to feel the slight tremors which will be felt in coming days, like logistic issues, availability of raw materials, etc., to the name a few. Friends, in this context, I would sincerely urge each and every one present in this program to utilize this wonderful opportunity in having fruitful and interactive dialogue with the officials from the customs, DGFT, MAPS, MSME, NSAC, and for the other forms of Tamil Nadu state government officers to mitigate the risks that are likely to be faced by our industry in this temporary slowdown. I would also like to make a special mention in Tamil Nadu Polymer Park. As an industry, thanks the Tamil Nadu state government for launching the Tamil Nadu Polymer Park for the benefit of the industry. Shlani Shekhar is unfortunately not attending this meeting. He is the Tamil Nadu government is recommended one for near Eddur Port. For that, Shlani Shekhar is the MP for that. I am sure that presentations lined up from the expert speakers will benefit all and also motive the budding MSME entrepreneurs to get into the exports in the very near future.
Honorable BGMT, Sir Lakappan, Sir Raman, Abdurrahman Hamdi, Mighty Industrialist. DGMT and Lux Council is organizing one of the wonderful events, that is awareness program on current scenario as well as the way forward. And you know that in Tamil Nadu there are 6.9 lakh units of small scale industries are there, and its share is around 15% all over India, and 32,000 crore of rupees being invested in small scale sector. And small scale sector is playing a key role in employment generation and production and in export market also.
Mr. Y.P. Rao, Mr. Chairman, Flex Council South, and Mr. S. Rakappa, President of Tamil Nadu Plastic Manufacturers Association, Mr. Suresh Babuji, from MSME, Government of India, and our chief guest for today, Mr. M.K. Sharmagasundaran, IAS Development Commissioner, and my colleague and batchmate in DZFT, Mr. Shekhar, and Ruben. All of you, the members of Flex Council, members of TAPMA, and other manufacturers of plastic products, and Varukkum Vadakkam. This is a beautiful morning, and I was wondering whether we'll go ahead with this meeting or not, but thanks to Ruben, we are here together. And now I am looking at the program that he has put together, which is phenomenal, and especially for export awareness program, the kind of topics he has put up, export potential in plastics and packing material. Especially I am interested in two topics here, ease of doing exports. After your deliberations and presentations today, after our program is over, please let us know if there is anything more from customs that we can do for you in doing this ease of doing exports. We have come up with a lot of initiatives. We have been doing it for a long time, and that pace has increased of late. I wanted to share with you, I will share with you right now what are we doing in export ease of doing front. And one more very important thing that we have implemented quite some time back, which is self-sealing of e-sealing of export containers. And recently as 1 month back, I have implemented in Tennessee customs, first time in India, is RFID e-sealing of all FCL containers. We want to implement that for LCL containers also. So the topic e-sealing features and benefits would be very useful to you, because here in Chennai Customs, we encourage e-sealing of containers. So a lot of self-sealed e-seal containers, RFID e-seal containers come to us. Now we are, in across about 34 CFSs we are implementing this e-sealing for FCL containers. So Robin, all these topics are very, very timely for them. And coming to our customs initiatives for ease of doing business, the many initiatives most of you are already aware, but there are few things that I want to highlight, and I want to bring your focus, and I want to shine light on those initiatives, because if you really adopt it, they're very, very simple, but that would really make your life much easier. First thing I would like to in all your export processes, how many of you directly deal with customs?
Good morning, all of you. Respected Sekar sir, the zonal additional director general of foreign trade. Madam Sudha Koka, commissioner of customs, who has elaborately given the details with a passion. Mr. Suresh Babuji, the director for MSME Directorate. Mr. Y.V. Raman, Chairman, Southern Region of Lex Council. Mr. Rockappan, the President of Tamil Nadu Plastics Manufacturing Association. Mr. Ruben Hobde, the Regional Director for South Lex Council. Members, exporters of the council, exporters, of course the potential exporters, press and media, ladies and gentlemen, it is my immense pleasure to be here for this program. If I am not wrong, it was in the year 1862, the first man-made plastics was introduced. It was created by one Mr. Alexander Parkes, P-A-R-K-E-S, and he called that material as Parksin in his name itself. And he went to the great international exhibition held in 1862 in London and demonstrated that Parksin, P-A-R-K-E-S-S-I-N-E, which is a derivative from cellulose, can be heated and molded. After cooling, it retains its shape. So that's how the first plastic was introduced into the mankind. In 150 years of time, plastics has become integral part of our lives. Right from the dawn of the day, when we take up our toothbrush, to our another important part of our lives, this mobile phones, to the chairs we are all sitting, and many other aspects, all in which plastic is there. It has become absolutely an integral part of our lives. And I am sure that the plastic industry contributes to almost everyday requirement, right from clothing, to housing, to construction, to furniture, to automobiles, to household items, to agricultural products, to horticulture, irrigation, packaging, medical appliances, electronics, and electrical items. In so many ways, plastics is associated. It is also making significant contribution to the economic development and growth of various key sectors in the country, like automobiles, agriculture, construction, electricals, healthcare, textiles, and FMGCs, and many more to say. One of the fast-growing industries in India is also plastic industry. Plastic industry has been valued at $11 billion in 2018, demonstrating a double-digit growth over the last half a decade. That is tremendous.
Yeah. ஓகேவா?
ஆ ரெடி. ஓகே.
ஃப்ளெக்ஸ் கவுன்சில் மூலமாக இன்று இன்றைய ப்ரோக்ராம் இதில் நிறைய உயரதிகாரிகள் இருக்கின்றார்கள். பிளாஸ்டிக் என்று சொல்லுகின்ற போது சிங்கிள் யூஸ் பிளாஸ்டிக்கை எல்லோரும் தவிர்க்க வேண்டும் என்பது நம்முடைய மறுபடியும் ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கோம். பிளாஸ்டிக்கை பொறுத்தவரையில் நம்முடைய வாழ்க்கையினுடன் எல்லா இடங்களிலும் நீக்கமர நினைந்திருக்கிறது. நாம் அன்றாடம் உபயோகப்படுத்துகின்ற டூத் பிரஷிலிருந்து செல்போன்களிலிருந்து நாம் உட்கொறுகின்ற நாட்காலிகள் என்ற எத்தனையோ வகையான பொருட்களில் பிளாஸ்டிக் இருக்கிறது. சிங்கிள் யூஸ் பிளாஸ்டிக்கை நாம் அனைவரும் தவிர்க்க வேண்டும். அதுதான் இந்திய அரசுடைய கொள்கையும் கூட. அதுக்காக நிறைய நிகழ்ச்சிகள் நடத்தப்பட்டிருக்கின்றன, அவேர்னஸ் நிகழ்ச்சிகள் நடத்தப்பட்டிருக்கின்றன. பிளாஸ்டிக் என்று சொல்கின்ற போது நம்முடைய நாட்டிலிருந்து இந்த பிளாஸ்டிக் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியிலிருந்து 200 நாட்டிலிருந்து உலகமெங்கும் ஏற்றுமதி $11 பில்லியன் ஒவ்வொரு வருடமும் இந்தியாவிலிருந்து பிளாஸ்டிக் ஏற்றுமதி செய்யப்படுகிறது. இதில் இன்றைய நிகழ்ச்சியில் நிறைய ஏற்றுமதியாளர்கள் கலந்து கொண்டார்கள். அதை ஏற்றுமதியாளர்களை தவிர மற்ற சிலர் நிறைய பேர் இந்த இண்டஸ்ட்ரிக்குள் வருவதற்காக இந்த தொழிலில் வருவதற்காக தொழில் முனைவோராக இருப்பதற்காக இங்கு வந்திருக்கிறார்கள். அவர்களுக்கும் இது ஒரு இன்ட்ரடக்டரி செஷனுக்காக இங்கு வந்திருக்கிறது. இண்டஸ்ட்ரியை பொறுத்தவரையில் ஒரு மிகப்பெரிய எதிர்காலம் இந்திய ஏற்றுமதியாளர்களுக்காக காத்திருக்கிறது. அதற்கான ஒரு தொடக்க நிகழ்ச்சியாக இதை நாம் சொல்ல முடியும். அதே சமயத்தில் இந்த ஒரு தடவை மட்டும் உபயோகப்படுத்தக்கூடிய பிளாஸ்டிக் பொருட்களை குறைக்கணும். அது 50 மைக்ரான்களுக்கு குறைவாக இருக்கிறது. இதை தாண்டி ஒரு பெரிய பிளாஸ்டிக் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி இருக்கிறது. அதில் நம்முடைய ஏற்றுமதியாளர்கள் பங்கேற்று நல்ல முறையில் சிறப்படைய வேண்டும் என்பதற்கும் காரணமாக தான் இந்த நிகழ்ச்சி ஏற்பாடு செய்யப்படுகிறது.
சண்முகசுந்தரம் ஒரு நிமிஷம் இப்போ சொல்லுங்கள்.
சண்முகசுந்தரம் ஆணையாளர், சென்னை சிறப்பு சுகாதாரம்.